Hi, I'm here with Anjali Ramachandran. You are one of the directors at Storythings, which is a story studio based in London. And you're also the founder of Ada's List, which is a global community for women in tech.
That's right.
Take those two together, and we're talking about our class you're going to teach tonight for Chase Academy. And it will be about storytelling on complex issues. So complex issues have always been around. Issues like gender, identity, racism, colorism, etc. They have always been around, but technology has changed the way we tell stories about them.
That's right.
In what way?
So technology is used by people as a tool to further their goals. And from a storytelling perspective, it means that you can give voice to a number of people in very different ways, both for good and for bad. Talking about things like politics, for example, where it works either way. But even in the use of platforms and services, like all the social media platforms, trolls have a much bigger voice, for example. And these give rise to not only stories, but issues that need to be traversed when you are talking about these stories and communicating the good and the bad of these platforms. Mm-hmm. What's always important for us at Storythings, at least, in terms of storytelling, is the voice of the protagonist. You need to find the person whose story you want to tell. But that's very often not where we start. Mostly it's not where we start. We need to think about things like, and technology is crucial in forcing our change in thinking. Think about behavior. So what kind of behavior do you want your audiences to show or you know, just display when they watch your videos or content stories? Who are your audiences? First of all, are they teachers? Are they parents? Are they entrepreneurs? Are they policymakers and lobbyists? Students? What are the formats that resonate with them? That will dictate your choice of format. And what is the structure of the story that you want to tell? Then you get to the story itself and the person or people whose voices you want to represent.
Okay.
I think it's very important that technology, you don't put technology first. It's always the story, the voice that is first. That will dictate whether you want to create a podcast or a piece of graphic art, like a poster, a piece of documentary film, a long form editorial piece, or anything in between. And the beauty of technology is that you can now combine, mix and match a lot of them. At Storythings, we've used things like sort of moving image, but just audio at the background to protect the identities of vulnerable communities whose stories we've had to tell. And I think that's, again, very, very important. Especially when you're talking about issues like identity in the modern age, biometrics, climate change, policy issues, a lot of them very often, it's important to think about the communities who are affected, and very often they don't want to or shouldn't be identified. So ethics is a big part of what we do as well. We talk to experts in this field all the time, it's important for us to respect the lives of the people whose stories we tell. And I'll be talking a bit more about all this during the class, but I think overall, because of the complexities that we face in our day-to-day lives, thanks to technology, it's important to consider the 360 degree view. Very often what we talk about is not black and white, it's gray. It's the various, it's the things in between that don't get spoken about for whatever reasons. It means that people often want to spend more time with what we have to say because it helps them learn something new. And I think that is important as well.
So they start watching a particle and then they dive deeper and deeper in the
That's
story,
right.
Grabbing all kinds of different elements of content?
That's right. And that is what makes a real complex narrative, actually. It's not straightforward. You have different elements to it. You can enter the narrative in many, many ways, or you can continuously explore things through a series as opposed to just one tweet. The other thing with technology is that it places your content out of context. People can see it anywhere, everywhere, in a stream most likely, given mobile, and you have to think about that. And so one piece of content can't tell the whole story, and so you create something for them, a world for them to explore.
And how do you avoid people to take one of the particles out of the 360 universe and use it for the, own purposes?
Yeah, for their own purposes. I mean, a lot of the content that we create is created under Creative Commons, which means anyone can take it and republish it, reuse it, but with certain reasonable limits in mind. To your question, I mean, with the rise of you know, things like deepfakes, I don't think it's possible for anyone to ever say that, you know, your content will not be used for nefarious purposes. But I think if you consider the very seriously the ethics and the issues at hand, you will reach the right people, and with any luck, it won't fall into the wrong hands for wrong purposes.
Okay, I'm very curious to know more. Thank you so much.
Pleasure. And, looking forward to it.
I wish you good luck with the lecture.
Thank you.